Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture series of electric circuits and network. Today in this session we are going to discuss about series RL and RC circuits. So let's compare them. The first parameter is circuit diagram. In a series RL circuit indicates that the resistance R and inductance L are in series across applied voltage V, small v equals to Vm sine of omega t. This is the current flowing through the circuit, small I. Vr is the voltage across resistance, Vl is the voltage across inductor. Similarly, in series RC circuit, R and C are in series, which is across the applied voltage, small v equals to Vm sine of omega t. This is the current flowing through the circuit, small I. Vr is the voltage across resistor and Vc is the voltage across this capacitor. Then let's draw the phasor diagram. Here these two are series circuit, so current is common in series elements. So current is taken as a reference. This is the current vector I. In case of resistance, the voltage across resistance and current through the resistors are in phase. We have already seen this. Voltage across resistor and current through the resistor are in phase with each other. So Vr can be drawn on the same line. In case of inductance, voltage Vl, current through the inductor lags behind voltage by 90 degree. Current through the inductor lags behind voltage Vl by 90 degree. So Vl should be drawn in upward direction with 90 degree phase difference between voltage and current, so that current will lag voltage by 90 degree. This is Vr, this is Vl. This total voltage V, supply voltage, is the vector sum of Vr plus Vl. So by joining these two points we will get the total voltage V. This voltage is the vector sum of Vr plus Vl. This is the angle between current and voltage phi. From this phasor diagram we can say that current I lags voltage V by angle of phi, by phase angle phi. Similarly, in case of series RC circuit, let's take current I as a reference, current vector I as a reference. Same in case of resistance, voltage across resistance and current through the resistors are in phase with each other, so Vr can be drawn on the same line. Then in case of capacitance, current leads voltage by 90 degree, so I leads voltage Vc by 90 degree. Current is already drawn, so Vc should be drawn in downward direction so that current leads Vc by 90 degree. This will be the Vc, this will be the Vr. And total voltage V is the vector sum of Vr and Vc. So joining these two points we will get the supply voltage V. This is the phase angle phi. From phasor diagram we can say that current I leads voltage V by angle phi. Okay. Then next, voltage and current equation. From phasor diagram we can write easily that small v is equal to Vm sine of omega t. Same in RC circuit, small v is equal to Vm sine omega t. In RL series circuit, I is lagging by angle phi. So Im sine of omega t minus phi, minus for lagging. And this is the phi phase angle, which is less than 90 degree. It is between 0 and 90 degree. In series RC circuit, current leads voltage by angle phi. So I will be Im sine of omega t plus phi. Plus indicates lead. Here minus indicates lag. This is phi is the phase angle, but angle is less than 90 degree, that is 0 to 90 degree. The phase relationship between voltage and current, as the phase angle is less than 90 and it is negative, so current lags voltage by angle phi, which is less than 90. In case of series RC circuit, phase angle is plus phi. Plus indicates leads, so current leads voltage by angle phi less than 90 degree. Voltage and current waveform. Here, the voltage and current waves are drawn. In case of RL circuit, the current lags voltage by angle phi. Here voltage start, here current is starting later, that is delay by phi angle. So it will show that I lags voltage by phi angle. In this figure, as series RC circuit, current leads voltage by phi angle, so it should start before voltage. This is the starting point, 0 is the starting point for voltage, and this is the starting point for current. So current is started earlier than the voltage, so we can say that current leads voltage by angle of phi. The next, let's calculate impedance of the circuit. In series RL circuit, we can write Z is equal to R plus jXL. R is present also, inductance is present, so inductive reactance also present, ohm. In polar form, we can written Z as Z is equal to mod of Z at an angle of theta. Mod of Z is equal to under root of R square plus XL square, and theta is nothing but tan inverse of XL upon R. In series RC circuit, Z is equal to R minus jXC, so Z is equal to mod of Z at an angle minus theta, which is where mod of Z is equal to under root of R square plus X square, and angle is tan inverse of minus XC upon R. This will be the impedance of the circuit. Then powers in circuit, in series RL and series RC circuit, all three powers are present: active power, reactive power, and apparent power. P is equal to VI cos phi in watts, Q is equal to VI sin phi in volt ampere reactive, and S is equal to VI volt ampere. Similarly, in series RC circuit, P is equal to VI cos phi watts, Q is equal to VI sin phi VAR, and S is equal to VI volt ampere. Only difference between this Q power is the reactive power due to inductance, and this is the Q is the reactive power due to capacitance. Now let's see power factor. As the cos phi is less than 1 for series RL circuit, phi is less than 90 degree, that is between 0 to 90 degrees, so cos phi will be less than 1, and it is lagging in nature due to inductance, presence of inductance. In series RC circuit, cos phi less than 1, but it is leading in nature because capacitor is present in the circuit. This is all about the series RL circuit and series RC circuit. Let's solve some numericals. First numerical is, a RL series circuit consists of 120 ohm resistance and 0.15 Henry inductance. The series circuit is connected across a 100 volt 50 hertz AC supply. Calculate current and voltage across individual elements. Given data, first we will write given data. RL series circuit is given, R is equal to 120 ohm, inductance L is equal to 0.15 Henry, voltage V is equal to 100 volt, and frequency F is equal to 50 hertz. Where to find current, voltage across resistor, and voltage across inductor? This circuit diagram shows the RL series circuit having the given values 120 ohm, 0.15 Henry, and current I, and this is the applied voltage V is equal to 100 volt 50 hertz. Let's calculate one by one. Step 1, calculate the reactance and impedance. Here is the inductor is present, so reactance of inductor XL is equal to 2 pi FL, putting the values of F and L. 2 pi into 50 into 0.15, we will get the value of 47.12 ohm. This is the value of reactance. Then similarly, we can calculate impedance. As we know, impedance is equal to under root of R square plus XL square for RL series circuit. Putting their values under root of 120 square plus 47.12 square is equal to 128.92 ohm. This is the value of impedance. The next step, calculate current. I is equal to V upon Z. According to Ohm's law, I is equal to V upon Z. So equals to V value 100 and 128.92 is equal to 0.7757 ampere. Then step number 3, calculate individual voltage, that is voltage across resistor and voltage across inductor. We have VR is equal to I into R, so 0.7757 into 120, we get 93 volt, and VL is equal to I into XL, 0.7757 into 47.12, 36.55 volt. This will be the required values. The next numerical, a circuit has a resistance of 100 ohm and inductance of 0.5 henry. It is connected to 230 volt 50 hertz AC supply. Calculate inductive reactance, impedance, current and power factor of the circuit. The circuit is drawn as RL series circuit having the values of 100 ohm and 0.5 henry inductance. This is the voltage 230 volt and the frequency is given as 50 hertz. We have written the given data, RL series circuit, resistance, inductance, voltage and frequency. Where to find here XL, Z, I and power factor cos phi. Let's calculate. Step 1, first calculate the inductive reactance. We know XL is equal to 2 pi into 50 into 0.5, 157 ohm. Then calculate the impedance under root of R square plus XL square, and this is the phi angle tan inverse of XL upon R. Putting their values, we get 186.14 at an angle of 57.50. This is the value of impedance and this is the phase angle. Then calculate current with the help of voltage and impedance. I is equal to V upon Z equals to 230 upon 186.14 equals to 1.24 ampere. This is the value of required current. Then power factor. Power factor is nothing but cos phi. Phi value is 57.50, so cos of 57.50 is 0.537 lagging. This will be the required power factor. The next, a resistance of 5 ohm and capacitive reactance of 10 ohm are connected in series if the current through the circuit is 3 ampere. Find total voltage, power factor and its nature. Assume frequency is 50 hertz. RC series circuit is drawn with given values R is equal to 5 ohm, X is equal to 10 ohm. Current is given 3 ampere and voltage with frequency 50 hertz. Given data written, we have to find here voltage and power factor. First, calculate the impedance. Z is equal to under root of R square plus X square. So, under root of 5 square plus 10 square equals to 11.18 ohm. This is the value of impedance. Calculating total voltage, we have I is equal to V upon Z. So, V is equal to I into Z. So, putting values 3 into 11.18 is equal to 33.5 volt. This is the value of total voltage. Then phase angle, phi can be calculated as tan inverse of minus XC upon R because it is a RC series circuit, is equal to tan inverse of minus 10 upon phi equals to minus 63.43. Then calculating the power factor, cos phi is equal to cos of minus 63.43 is equal to 0.4472 leading. These are the numericals based on the learned topics. Remaining topics will be covered in the next videos. Till then, stay tuned and keep learning.